of friendship, adventure, courage, jealousy and togetherness. We just now be having fun.
Childhood, because of you, I laugh a little harder, cry a little less, and smile a lot more.
Our affectionate welcome to esteemed dignitaries, our lighthouse and trailblazer, Honorable Principal Sir, Mr. Saji V. Matthew, Vice Principal, respected Mrs. Sophia Saji, School Administrator, Mr. Anil Thomas, adorable parents and our DCS family, with this special occasion that promises to be filled with drama, humor, excitement and incredible performances. My name is Adya.
And I'm Anushree. And we will be taking you through this journey, the exciting world of Theatre Fiesta 2023, featuring the adventures of Tom Sawyer.
To witness an exceptional performance that has been a month in the making, our talented actors and technical team have poured their hearts and souls to bring this act to life.
Before we begin, let's take a moment to appreciate the magic of theatre. The stage transforms into myriad worlds and epochs. The actors transcend themselves to bring diverse characters to life. And we, the audience, are transported, enchanted, moved and challenged.
Absolutely, Anushree. At this event, we embark on the captivating journey to the adventures of Tom Sawyer, written by the American author Mark Twain, and it will come alive by the hard work and dedication of our incredible cast and crew.
Let's have it a glimpse of it. The Adventures of Tom Sawyer is a gripping tale of chance adventure. The story is a perfect balance of adventures, friendships, superstition, love and humor.
Blended with mischievous nature and active imagination, the protagonist Tom spends most of the novel getting himself and often his friends into and out of trouble. Overall, the novel traces Tom's development from childish immaturity to a state of little maturity.
But Adya, now as we wait for the play to begin, let's use this opportunity to appreciate the hand that has crafted various elements that make our drama so spectacular. The detailed set design, the props, the costumes and all these elements we witness here have been created by our technical team that breathed life into the script and has created this mesmerizing world we see on the stage. And yes, the lighting, the music and the direction have added their magical spell into it.
So hold your breath and get ready to meet them who have worked behind the scenes to make this event happen. Introducing the backbone of today's event, our technical team. Let's share them with a great round of applause. So sit back and relax and get ready to be transported into a world of great intensity, passion and unforgettable performances.
Well, I will if you fool with me.
Oh, yeah?
You and whose army, huh? Smarty, you think you're something with a dumb hat?
You can knock my hat if you don't like it. I dare you to knock this hat off of my head. And anybody who'll take a dare and suck eggs.
If you give me much more OS sass, I'll take a bounce rock off in your head.
Oh, of course you will.
Well, I will.
Well, why don't you do it then? It's because you're afeard.
I ain't afeard.
Yes, you are.
Get away from here.
Get away yourself.
I won't.
I won't neither.
You're a coward. I'll tell my big brother and he can thrash you with his little fingers and I'll make him do it so.
What are IKEA for your big brother, huh? I got a brother bigger than yours.
That's a lie.
You're saying, so don't make it so.
I dare you to step over that and I lick you till I can't stand up. Anybody that'll take a dare is steal sheep.
Well, you said you can do it. Why don't you do it then?
Don't crowd me now. You better look out.
Well, you said you can lick me. So why don't you do it then?
By Jingo, 4 to 6, I will.
Not like me, huh?
Said?
He's always acting a fool.
Now say, you know, the good book says, he who calls his brother a fool is in danger of hellfire. We'll have no more of that earth and your hide.
Tom's a boy, a bad boy, and he's gonna grow up and go to jail.
Tom! Tom! Thomas Sawyer!
Ain't Polly!
Well, where have you been? Didn't you hear me calling you? Speak up! Where have you been?
He's been hiding in the pantry, stealing jam, Aunt Polly.
40 times I've said you, don't let that jam alone at can you? Sit, hand me that washcloth.
Oh, you're killing me! Oh, look out! You'll put out my eyes! Ouch!
Then just sit down there and eat your supper. And I don't want to hear another word out of you. Tom!
Oh, what are you hitting me for? I never done nothing. It was Sid. I always get blamed for everything.
That's right, Mama. It was Sid. Tom wasn't doing the thing.
Sid, you oughtn't to do that. Tom, I reckon you didn't get a lick amiss. Tom, it was middling government school today, weren't it?
Yes,
powerful bomb, weren't it?
Yes, I guess so.
Did you want to go to a swimming, Tom?
Well, why? Not very much.
But ain't you too warm now?
Some of us stuck our heads under the water pump. Mine's damp here.
See? Tom, you'd have to undo your shirt collar when I sewed it to pump on your head. Did you? Stand up and let me see.
See?
Well, bother. Go along with you. I reckon you're better. And you look.
Well, now, I thought you sewed his collar with white thread, but it's sewed with black.
Why? I did sew it with white thread. Thomas Sawyer! Thomas Sawyer!
I get you, Sid. Getting me blamed for something you done, then telling me for playing hooky? I'll let you go first chance I get.
He's full of old scratch, but he's my own deaf sister's boy, and I ain't got that heart to really thrash him. Mary, if you had a brother, maybe I know better how to handle your cousin Tom.
Sid, you go on up to bed now. I'll come and hear your prayers after a while.
Night, auntie. I love you.
Yes, well, get on with you now.
Mama, you just set out on the veranda and I'll clean the dishes after I hear Sid's prayers. Don't worry none about Tom. He'll come home when he thinks you've gone to bed.
Well, you're going to paint that backyard fence tomorrow. Or I'm going to know the reason why. I hate to make him work on Saturday. But I gotta teach him. He can't just do as he pleases. I just can't figure the boy out. Jenny Sawyer, can you hear me? It's Tom, Jenny. I just don't know what to do with him. Try as I will. I can't always make him behave. I'm trying to be a mother to Tom. I'm trying to make him into a decent man. And I feel like I'm failing. I'm failing you, Jenny, and Tom. May Tom ain't the problem. Maybe the trouble with Tom is me.
Why not Tom weren't at school yesterday? These ways I didn't see him, not even during the spelling tea. And I was at the front of the class all the time, as I didn't even miss one word.
Yeah, sir. How do you spell mouth for a paint, Tom?
You missed the place, Tom. Aunt Polly will skin you if you don't do a proper job.
Yeah, sir. And as soon as ever I finish painting this fence, you're gonna be in a lot of trouble. You just wait.
Touch me and I'll tell Aunt Polly. Well now, I better get on over to the Horse Williams pasture for the dodgeball game. Too bad, you kid.
What a sissy. If Aunt Polly knew, what he is after doing when she ain't watching, and after stay and paint the fence on all Saturday instead.
Oh, there you are. What are you doing for Pete's sake? Ain't you wanna play ball with us?
No, Ben. No, my goodness, no. You think I'll be leaving fence painting for ball playing? Heck, a fella can play dodgeball on any old Saturday, but Ain does not allow me to paint the fence once a year. I'd rather paint the fence than go on fishing.
Tom, you, what have you just said? Me?
I mean it, all week long. I was waiting Aunt Polly to call me and say, Tom, you can paint the fence.
Are you plumb crazy? Painting the fence is a job, not fun.
Not the one who must be joshing. For everyone knows that painting the fence is even more fun, even playing than hooky. See how I can draw a pirate ship?
That's a mighty keen pirate ship. Let me try, Tom, please.
Yeah, I can even test stone, paper, scissors.
I lose, Tom. Play me again, Tom. If I win, I get to paint the fence. Woohoo! I won!
Alright, Ben. I lose. You can paint the fence for a little while.
Honestly, for your own hard work. Now run along.
But mind you get back sometime this week. I'll tan you, boy.
Blessed are the
poor.
Yes, poor. Blessed are the poor
in spirit.
In spirit. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for they oh rats, I nodded last night.
For theirs. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
Tom, Mary, gonna be late for your Sunday school. Sydney left here 5 minutes ago. Move along now.
Yes, Mama. All right, Tom. One more time.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, for they in the kingdom of God. I done it.
Amen. Except it's heaven, Tom. The kingdom of heaven. Now school, or we're gonna be late for Sunday school. Mama, are you coming with me?
No, child. Me and the brother Douglas are fixing the communion. I'll see you in church. Both of you. Now don't let that boy run off.
Now, Tom, don't order. Come on in.
Cousin Mary, do I have to? Can't us do the fellows, please.
I reckon, Tom, if you give me a word, you won't start pulling. You can sit with the boy. But mind you, Tom, no talking during Sunday school.
Last Sunday, I learned 10 words. How many you got?
Ain't telling, But I got two white tickets for learning one verse, but a heap more, like some yellow and blue mostly. Well, it didn't look like I'm showing off, but I think you got no nerve tickets for winning no kind of prize. Wanna swap him with the rat you paid me?
Really, Tom? I'm powerful. Found that rat. Here's all I got.
Hey, how's about my doorknob, Tom?
Hey, how's about it?
Can't I have my doorknob back too, Tom?
Well, I ain't got much use for the more tickets. What with the verses I learned? But I got some marbles in case you can swap.
Bye, Tom.
Ooh, bye.
Hot dog! All I gotta do is now step into those and win the contest!
Hey,
Holly! I was waiting for you to come here. Alright, morning, little Douglas.
Morning, Thomas. Polly, you sure do a wonder cleaning that boy up for a Sunday school.
Why? It's a labor of love, Miss Douglas. The children are trial to me, but they give me a feeling of having something to do and someone to love. The Lord's been good to me.
Amen. Oh, Polly, sometimes I wish I had a boy to take care of. I need to give love to a child. Ever since my husband died, I feel myself a drying up and getting to become useless. Oh, I do wish I had a young one to raise.
Well, Miss Douglas, I'm not too sure to know all that you are is a wishing. But young ones are a blessing. Come along, Tom.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Good people, we have come together on this glorious Sabbath day to celebrate the achievements of our children, who are the Lord's. The usual order of the lesson is changed today so that these dear sheep who have labored for so long in learning the words of the Holy Bible wouldn't have to wait no longer for the rewards. With us on this great occasion is a new and worthy member of our community, Judge Thatcher, who will present the prizes. We'll do the voice part first. As I call your names, please call out how many tickets you have won. Sid Sawyer has won twice and therefore is not eligible. Ben Rogers, are you here?
Yes, sir.
How many blue tickets do you have, Ben?
I reckon, sir, I ain't got any tickets at all.
Why, Ben? I'm right down surprised at you. How about you, Ted Austin?
No, sir. Me neither. I ain't got neither.
Jim Hollis?
Sir, I reckon I lost most of them. But I can say the verse is honest.
You know the rules, Jim. The one with the most ticket gets the prize. Why, that's it. Joe Harper? I know. You must have won most of them.
No, sir, I don't. Not many a one.
Well, does anybody have any tickets? Tom Sawyer?
Yes, sir. I got lots and lots of tickets here. See?
I was just certain of you. Of everybody wouldn't have learned more than a few verses. Now, if you come over here and stand over by me, Thomas. Ladies and gentlemen, Judge Thatcher.
Thank you, my friend. It really warms my heart to be asked to participate in this joyous occasion and to present the prize to such a fine, upstanding young man. A credit to his family, to St. Petersburg, to state of Missouri, and to our great nation. But first, I'd like you all to meet my family. My wife, Mrs. Thatcher. My son, Jeff. And my little girl, Rebecca. On behalf of my family, I want to thank each one of you for making us welcome to St. Petersburg. Now, young man, what's your name?
Tom.
What's your Christian name?
Thomas.
Thomas what?
Say, Sir Thomas.
Sir Thomas, tell us your full name, son.
Thomas Sawyer, sir.
Well, Thomas, congratulations. It's my great privilege to present you with this holy Bible, leather-bound Bible. But first, to show us what you have learned, tell the name of the first two disciples.
The first two disciples?
Yes, son, the first two disciples.
The first two?
Yes, son, the first two disciples.
Oh, the first two disciples. Why, that'll be Timothy and Goliath.
Fishing.
Well, if it ain't all a fit, where are you going, Hockey?
Thought I'd go some fishing down by the creek. The catfish is supposed to be biting this week. No, Tom Sawyer. What on earth are you doing in your Sunday duds?
Ain't Polly making me wear the dumb old things till I didn't learn 100 Bible verses. I hate her. I think sometime I just run away.
Oh, Tom, you oughtn't to talk that way about your Aunt Polly. At least, she's someone who gives a damn about you. Why, I might even be willing to wear fancy clothes if an eye had them up. Well, part of the time, anyhow.
Heck fire, Huck. They tell me you got the best kind of living. Don't never have to go to school, don't never have to do nothing.
If I ain't got a mind to.
Wish I was you.
Sure, it would be nice to play Ookie from school and go fishing with you, Huck.
I'd go in a minute.
Me too.
Yeah, Huck's finally
lucky. There goes the bell. We're all gonna be late, and I'm gonna tell.
Oh, that sir makes me so mad. Come on in, he will tell on us. You know how he is.
Come on, Faith. We sure don't need to get into no trouble, or else we can't spend the night over at Amy's tonight. I'm coming.
Me too, Faith. Tom, I hope you get tan good for being late.
Come on, Tom, you know he will wail the daylights out if you're late again.
I don't care for his old bell. Tell, I was talking to Huck Finn.
Bye, Huck. Come on, Tom.
Well, Hucky, what you put here, huh? A old dead cat. See, it's all dried up.
Now what do you want with a dead cat?
Why, they is good for a lot of things. Getting rid of warts for one thing.
But they ain't near good as getting rid of warts as spunk water.
Spunk water? That's all you know, Tom. Spunk water will do the job. All right, if you do it proper. But a dead cat is just naturally a heap better.
I got a wart here right on my finger. I was planning to use spunk water on this evening. You have to dip your hand under the spunk water and say, barley corn, engine meal, shorts, spunk water, swallow this words. Then you have to move 11 steps by shutting your eyes, turn around and move to your home. Because if you speak, the charm will be busted.
Well, did you ever try it?
No, but Ben did and he hardly got any words left.
Well, if he used a dead cat, he wouldn't have none left.
Well, when are we going to try this war, or this cat?
Tonight, at the graveyard, I reckon. After all those villains tonight.
Who will?
Oh, the devils, of course, Tom. Sometimes I think you don't know none of nothing.
But the buried horse villains on Saturday. Mind the devils didn't take them on Saturday night?
It's after midnight, and then it's a Sunday. And devils don't slush about much on a Sunday. No, they'll come for him tonight.
Let me go with you.
Oh, of course, if you ain't afeard.
Afeard? Tain't likely. Will you meow?
Yeah, I will meow. And you meow back if you get a chance. Last time you kept me waiting out the neighbors went on throwing rocks at me.
I couldn't meow that night because Auntie was watching me. But I'll surely meow tonight.
Okay, well, I reckon. I'll be again on a fishing. See you about 11:30.
Bye.
Alright, boys and girls.
Come in.
Well, Mr. Sawyer, your brother tells me you are talking to Huck Finn. That's why you are late.
Yes, ma'am.
You must ride over and sit with girls. Ride over there, Travis. Alright, boys and now settle down. Your assignment was preparing on recitation of theme. Why dogs are called man's best friend. Now who would like to go first? Faith, please come forward and begin.
The
Dogs are called men's best friend because all dogs are friends of all men. Some dogs are big and some dogs are small. All dogs have hair and sometimes fleas.
Good. Jim Hollis. Jim Hollis is next.
Ma'am, I forgot to do my assessment.
Assignment!
Sorry, ma'am, I forgot to do my assignment.
If that happened again, Jim Hollis, you will go to schoolyard and you get punished.
Sorry, ma'am.
Sit, Sawyer. Please come forward and begin.
Why dogs are called man's best friend? Why, Sid Sawyer? Dogs have played an important role in the service of a great nation, the United States of America. It is believed that General George Washington had a dog who helped him become the first president of our country and the father of our nation. And so, in ancient and present civilization, dogs have properly earned the title of man's best friend. Thank you.
Good! Alright, boys and girls, now settle down. As soon as everyone perfectly quiet, you may go home for lunch!
Shucks! Just tell her I shared my lunch with you. I can't go home today. Cause Aunt Polly and Cousin Mary are gonna visit Purple Ridge. So I brought my lunch. You can share.
Alright, I will. But you must not ever tell.
Mia!
Sir, you naughty cat!
Meow! Meow!
Quiet, you stinking cat!
Meow! Meow! Meow, meow, meow!
Concern that cat anyway!
Oh, Tom, did you have to meow so loud? You said for me to meow up, so I did. How else you want to hear it? Unless it was meow,
just
meow.
Just quiet down, Tom.
Next thing you know, the neighbors start shooting on us. Come on, it's after 11:30 and we gotta be in the graveyard before midnight.
And
me jailed for a vagrant. You think I forget, huh? And now I've got you. You've got to settle it. Here now, don't you hit my bar. Now, this ends for you. Now that score is settled. Now the devils take your soul. Lord, what's this joke? It's study business, Muff. What did you do it for?
I never done it.
Look, that kind of talk won't wash.
I thought I had got sober. I had no business to drink tonight. I am all in a muddle. Can't recollect a thing. Tell me, Joe, honest now.
Why, you two were scuffling and then he hit you one with that headboard right there. And then you got knocked out. Then up you came, staggering like, took and jammed that thing into him. And he hit you once again in the head. And here you have lying, dead as a bitch.
Oh, Joe, what am I gonna do? You ain't gonna tell, are you?
Now, Muff, you know I wouldn't tell for a soul. Come on, that's enough. Now start moving and remember to leave no traces.
Ha, 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 ha!
Oh, Hucky, what did I get come of this?
Doc Robinson's dead, Tom. That'll mean hanging for sure. Poor old Muff Potter. He's always been kind to me. He even fed me and looked after me when my pap beat me and left the town. It ain't right for him to hang where it wasn't Joe who killed the dog.
Who did?
Us! No, Tom. Suppose something happened and Injun Joe did not hang. Why, he'd kill us sometime or the other. As dead sure as we are standing here.
You sure you can keep Mum?
Gotta keep Mum, Tom. Let's take an oath and swear. Give me your hand. We swear we will keep Mum about this, and we wished we may drop down dead in our tracks if when we ever tell and rot.
Oh, Tom, you can kiss me if you wanna.
Tom, I'm sorry. Let's make up.
Oh, Tom, I hate you.
Wait, Mickey.
I hate you, Tom Sawyer.
I can explain, Mickey.
You are a liar, Tom Sawyer.
I hate you. Hate you, Thomas Sawyer.
It didn't mean nothing really, Mickey. Please wait.
Don't you try to get me to kiss you again, leading me on when you like Becky better. Go away, Tom.
Oh, Becky, please wait.
You are a rotten mean boy, Tom. I hate you.
I hate you, Tom.
Don't like neither one of them. I don't like nobody. I don't like Sid. I don't like Aunt Polly. I don't like no one. Cause they don't like me. I just run away. You.
What's your name, boy? Speak up when I speak to you.
What? Tom.
Well, I think you already know me, huh? Aren't you one of those kids who have been sneaking around the old tannery behind Widow Douglas's house? Aren't you?
No, sir. I ain't one of them at all.
Well, if you see any of them, you better tell them to stay away. I got permission from Widow Douglas because I ain't got no place to stay elsewhere.
Sure, I'll tell any of them. You can count on me, sir.
Well,
boy. You know where the old constable's at?
Why? Yes, sir. Well, he and all the men are gone to find old Muck Potter at the cottage. I heard he was hiding there.
Oh, so they are finally catching the murderer, huh?
Yes, sir.
Alrighty then.
Hey, Tom.
What's up?
Hucky. I'm glad you're here, boy. You know, Indian Joe came from behind and grabbed me. But all he wanted was, do I know where the constable is and stay away from the old place of old Tandry where he sleeps. Oh, Hucky, I got never been down there.
Have you, Hucky?
Yeah, I've been down there and that ain't all. I found a treasure map hid there. See?
Oh, Hucky, get rid of it. If Injun Joe finds out about this, he'll cut your heart out and eat it. He's the meanest person ever, getting blamed to old Muff Potter for killing Dr. Robinson.
You better keep mum, Tom.
Yeah, Hucky. But Hucky, I think Injun Joe has figured out something. Did you see how he looked at us? I think we gotta run away. We just gotta run away.
Where to, Tom? Where to? There ain't no place safe.
But we can go to islands and be pirates. And then everyone will be sorry for the way they treated us. And Injun Joe will never able to find us.
Oh yeah, Tom. You're right. Come on.
We are gonna be pirates.
Woo-hoo.
We are gonna be pirates.
We are gonna be pirates.
We are gonna be pirates.
Woo-hoo.
Hey!
Tom,
my phone. Papa died of grief thinking he was drowned. Are you okay, child?
Yeah, Mama, I'm fine. Thank you.
Where was your boy?
Well, we have been in the islands to become pirates because nobody liked us and we always get licked and blamed for everything. But then I thought about you and Polly and heard Cousin Mari planning for the funeral. Then I cried at Polly. I literally cried. Then I told everything to Huck and we came as fast as we could. I'm sorry, Polly.
Well, you can thrash me if you want.
I got it coming. You sure do, Tom Sawyer.
Well, is it all for me?
Come, Huck.
Everyone, let's go home. And I'm going to bake a cherry pie with cream on top.
Yeah!
Folks, I never meant to do it. Somehow, it don't seem possible. I could have done it. There wasn't nobody else but Injun Joe. But Joe didn't done it. So I reckon I must.
Come on, Potter. This is court session. And we are gonna give you hanging. And you saw with your own eyes? Where defendant Potter stabbed and killed Dr. Robinson?
I did. Okay. And I saw him drop the body too.
You may step down. Your Honor, that's the prosecution's case. Clear and simple.
Does the defendant have anything to say? Your Honor, there ain't nothing I can say. I can only out my mind with Devon Rum. I never even hurt a fly before.
So you confess the crime?
I got something to say, Your Honor!
Well, son, this is most unusual, but I suppose we should hear everything that bears on the case. Now, come on. Come here. Now, put your hands on the Bible and say, I swear, I will tell the truth,
the whole truth,
nothing but the truth. Now, son, tell us what you know.
Well, Your Honor, me and Huck were there on the graveyard at that night. And we saw whole thing what happened. It was not my fault at all! It was Injun Joe!
Injun Joe
did it!
You kids, you will pay for this!
Catch
him! Come on, let's get him!
Tom.
Hush, Becky. Oh, me and Huck are dead.
According to the map, the X is right here. Come on, Tom.
Please, I want to go back home.
Hush now, Becky.
I'm so tired.
Oh, move over, Becky. Oh, Tom, there is a chest. There is a chest, sort of. Come on.
See, it's a lot of money.
There's lots and lots of money. I bet there's $1 million in there.
And now I've got you. Get away from the money. Get away from the money. It's mine. It's mine. I hid it here.
Hucky, you run for help. I take cover, Becky.
I get you, Tom Sawyer. You set the constable on me. And today is your end.
Tom, I'm here! Tom, I'm here! Come, constable! Come on, Joe! It's time to meet your doom!
Tom Sawyer! You will pay for this!
Well, these two young men have saved my little girl's life.
Father, see what we have found.
Well, I don't see any legal reason why these youngsters shouldn't have the equal amount in the treasure they found.
Three cheers for three youngsters! Hip hip hooray! Hip hip hooray! Hip hip hooray!
You can tell me how much you hate me.
No, it's not what I want to say. In fact, I wanted to apologize for earlier. Will you still be ready to get engaged?
Sure, Becky. Why not?
Thank you, Tom.
Will you always choose me?
Yes, I will always choose you.
It is remarkable what a group of dedicated and passionate individuals can achieve together.
As you wrap this selling event, we would like you to meet our star cast. With great anticipation and thrill, let's welcome our star cast on the stage.
Thank you.
power of theatre is immense. And this act of theatre was a perfect example of that power. We hope that you enjoyed the experience as much as we enjoyed presenting it to you.
As we come to the end of this event, before we take your leave, we would like to extend our heartfelt gratitude to the team, Footlight, beloved Gauri ma'am, Bhavya sir, Ayu sir and Koyal ma'am for the guidance to exhibit this journey of Tom Sawyer.
On this occasion, we thank all the parents who took us on this unforgettable journey of Tom Sawyer and encouraged us by their presence.
Finally, we would like to thank the entire DCIS family for the unfailing support to make this event a successful one.
With gratitude, now we conclude this act of theatre. As it dim our lights, we only brighten our anticipation for more such shared journeys.
On this note, we bid you goodbye and look forward to welcoming back soon for more such incredible journeys. Thank you all.
For the exhibition that has been arranged in Block A, and kindly join us for the refreshments after your visit. You are requested to collect your ward from Block A only.
Can I just have one more minute?
Thank you.
Can Koyal ma'am come forward?
She is the one who trained the band there.
You have seen the performance of your kids. How was it? We know. I mean, we were worried how things will go, but in the end, it has all come up wonderfully well. As the children have already mentioned, an exhibition. Now that you have seen the surroundings and all, you will be able to identify what is put up in the exhibition. Please see the exhibition. Every prop, every exhibit that you see is made by the children. So the two teams, technical, which made everything, and then the performing team, those who came here to perform. So everyone has worked hard. Believe us, you know, teachers have just a guiding role here. It is the children who have done everything, right? So definitely a big congratulations to the entire team. But then for us, there is one more requirement. You know, as I mentioned earlier, there will be a feedback form, a QR code is there. Kindly scan it. You know, when you go to Block A, see the exhibition, then kindly, you know, scan, give your feedback. You know, the biggest fear that most of us have is stage fear. You know, when you come to the stage, whether you are able to say something, perform something, and these kids have shown, they are different from us. They have much more confidence than what we have. So God bless them. May they do much better. Thank you all for being here. If anyone would like to come here and share a word or two, it would be wonderful. Otherwise, you know, we will move to blocking. Anyone would like to share a word? Thank you, sir.
Just I come here with not the expectation what the kids perform. Single word, it is an amazing. The way they deliver the dialogues, the way they timely they coordinate, it shows the hard work what they have taken for the last 1 year. Thanks to this speech for making this wonderful.
Thank you so much. Thank you. So, please.
My son has been here in this school since 2016, and every year we are amazed and we are very happy that you did something like this. My job is something in which I interact with children when they are a little older than what they are right now, and it is these kind of children who do very well in their life. So thank you all of you for doing such an incredible job.
Thank you so much.
Have noticed even the props and the setting were managed by the children only. They were running here, but you know, it's their timing.
Yes, sir. Respected principal, sir, and parents. Divine mein mera experience senior KG se hai. Main Pratishthit ka parent hu. Pratishthit jo bhi kuch hai, wo aaj divine ki wajah se hai. केवल एजुकेशन में नहीं, को करिकुलर एक्टिविटी से लेकर उसका स्पेसपियर से लेके जो और सब कुछ वैल्यू बेज जो बिहेव करते हैं ना बच्चे, वो सब कुछ डिवाइन की वजह से। थैंक्स प्रिंसिपल सर।
थैंक यू सर। थैंक यू सो मच।